just coming from Moi, I was shocked. Every time I walked every floor, every lecture room was open. And the sockets were there. And the projector is there. And nobody closes doors. I kept on telling my staff, why are doors open? You know we have projectors. They were looking at me and getting worried. Nobody touches those things. Nobody. Nobody touches. So when I go to a lecture hall, I just walk with my laptop, either connect through Bluetooth or connect to the wall. And the projector is there, and it will remain there. I've been one of those lecture halls. I know it can't be, but because I've seen sockets. Where you go with a laptop and you can't plug it in. And then the students who are here, let me tell you, there is no pride in being dirty. That's what CBC is saying. There's no pride. Like when I was a headmaster of a school in Mumias, Ubino Boys, we had a physics teacher who was just dirty. His hair is unkempt. He uses one shirt almost the whole week. And you know, he doesn't care. He walks around with open shoes on it. And he thinks he's very tough because he's teaching physics. My students just choose to be clean. Because cleanness is next to godliness. Yes. So me in my lecture halls, even at Moi, I did not tolerate that. Because when then me, I'll walk out and leave in the class. Because me, I'm clean. So me, I don't want to have problems with smelling socks, you know, armpits, at a deodorant, the cheapest, squeeze at a kwa kiosk. So that you are not sticking everywhere you go. Where was I? No, I was telling my first year parents about the students coming. These students who don't do any chores at home, they don't do anything. Because their father is a professor or a what, they don't do anything. They just sleep. They wake up, they don't even spread their bed. You know, a military officer in a book wrote, somebody who does not spread his bed will never become anything in life. And I know there's nobody here who doesn't spread his bed. So when you wake up, by the way, when you wake up, the first thing, and I'm talking to the men here, the young men, the first thing is to spread your bed. That is the first measure of discipline. Yeah. Some of you, when you get married, if your wife has gone for a course, that bed will not be spread for the whole week she's away. Unaingia tu nalala, alafu unatoka mwanzo. And the worst bit is this one. The young men who are here. I don't know if this is Africa. Me, I find it very hard. I can't tolerate. These are the values we're talking about. I can't tolerate it. That I can go to a bathroom, I bathe, me now, and I leave the innerwear I've used today there for somebody to wash for me. I cannot, sir. So if mama is away for a week, when I put a five, I got a pass. You want to be clean. So after you bathe, just wash your innerwear. Do you become less of a husband? But you know, these are values you must carry. You must carry. By the way, how many of us, I'm talking to the students, not my colleagues. How many of us, we're talking about health and wellness. How many of us actually brush their teeth? You know, there are people who don't brush their teeth. Wanachukua mswaki, wanafanya hivi meno hivi. Ivi pisha. The biggest part to brush your teeth is the upper, the inside, and the lower. So you are there, your lecturers are passing by, you have terrible odor coming from your mouth, and these are things you can just do. Yeah. I'm talking about health and wellness. Environmental wellness, Guanavisi, I'm very, very excited. The grounds, flowers, they look very, 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 very good. And it makes a difference when you do that. Because you are training these young men, these are the next vice chancellors. These are the next principals of schools. Unaenda kwa shule, a principal has been there for 5 years and has not planted a single tree. And doesn't even realize that he has done nothing. Very, very important environmental awareness. Now, so these ones, Dean, you must begin to infuse them into your curriculum. Just these aspects we are talking about, global awareness, entrepreneurship, civic literacy. Civic literacy, do you know, I have one of my children, Prof. I went with him somewhere, and we were sitting at the table, and I was so embarrassed at Kempinski, the hotel. Yeah, Kempinski. So there was cutlery. You know the spoons, how they are arranged. Either your soup, once I eat. So the fellow is there. First of all, he holds a knife like this. I'm talking about civic literacy. Just being social literacy. Some of these students here, by the way, think it is macho to eat food with your hands. There's no problem. Me, I eat ugali with my hands, I host. But when you go elsewhere where they're using a fork and a knife, and you're a graduate of Kibabi High School, we expect that you know how to hold a fork. After the dinner in the cars, we were going home. We took a week teaching him how to use a knife and a fork because I was thoroughly embarrassed. And I know some of you are laughing, but if you go to sit at the table now, you don't even know which side the knife is, which side the fork is, because you think it is not important. Now, these are the 21st century skills, which again, the university must, we have already infused this in the curriculum at primary level. So you must be thinking,